There are two sets of factors that are weighing on rupee. Firstly, Fed has announced a series of measures to reduce the asset purchase program, which will be negative for liquidity, global liquidity, and will therefore have implication on risk asset, including INR. Secondly, crude has remained elevated. Now, this does not bode well for our current account deficit. Both these factors combined have a negative implication on the rupee. So there are two sets of countries in the emerging market space. Some are current account surplus and some are current account deficit. The current account deficit economies, in which India is also a part of, has depreciated in the range of 8 to 10%. India has depreciated by 9%. In the current account surplus economies, which are generally Asian economies, they have performed relatively better and have depreciated by a lesser amount, broadly in the range of 1 to 4%. Firstly, on growth, it hurts sentiment and therefore postpone investment decisions. Secondly, from an external sector perspective, our current account deficit might widen because of this, because imports are sticky in nature and therefore will lead to widening current account deficit. The authorities have taken a series of measures. RBI has announced a series of measures in terms of raising the cost of capital, which is rupee positive in the near term. Government has also taken a series of measures through FDI reforms, which is positive for rupee in the long term. We are expecting that the authorities will focus on few things. Firstly, reform process should continue. Focus should remain on growth. FDI norms should be eased as and when required. And NRI bonds are to be issued to support rupee in the near term, which will finance the current account deficit. All these measures will take away the sharp depreciation pressure from the rupee and will support. We are of the view that rupee has a floor of 58-59 in the near term, near to medium term. This is taking cognizance of the fact that crude prices will correct from elevated levels, and we will have more clarity on Fed action plan going forward.